This video is about how you can create the ultimate productivity system within Notion. It will let you take your short-term and long-term goals and then smash it together with a to-do list so that you can prioritize stuff and then actually do the things. This Notion page will give you the ability to measure progress as well as gain insight into your life. I'm going to show you my own productivity system that I use as a doctor, YouTuber, I do a bit of code sometimes, and basically I'm just trying to tie together all these things that I learn on the way into one neat system so I can take the different learnings that I have and direct it towards my goals. This productivity system is something that I myself use on a daily basis, and so I'm really excited to show you because I get to nerd out about it. The top of my productivity system naturally has Spy X Family, which is the anime I'm obsessed with at the moment, but let's go and look at the actual components of it. So on the top, you've got a to-do system. This to-do system literally, well, captures to-dos of any kind. And so whenever I have a new thought, it goes into this particular to-do bit, but you'll notice that it's kind of weird to do, right? Like, why does the to-do system have so many cells inside of it? It's actually a gigantic table, right? And so if you actually go down, this system is directed by the goals that I have. I have my infinite goals down here. So, you know, it includes things like having fun, creating wonderful things. I eventually want to contribute a fair bit of money to medical research and technology, and also to like make an anime studio one day, because I think that'd be sick. And also to become a great doctor for fun. And then I have my annual goals. So these are the ones that from a year to year basis, and these are actually connected to my infinite goals. So for example, this goal, this lofty goal of publishing a 1 million view worthy video every fortnight. I mean, you know, it's a goal. It's not necessarily something that I can achieve, but I will want to, you know, ideally try to achieve 5 videos with 1 million views by the end of the year. Can I get there? Dunno. Can I do it? I have no idea whatsoever, but it's worthwhile trying anyway. If the goal has to be so high that even if I can't necessarily realistically achieve it, at least I know that I can take steps to achieve it. You know, for example, thinking about the titles and thumbnails, thinking about the storytelling, and really amping those up in a way that makes it at least worthy of 1 million views. We're not there yet because it's very early days for this channel, and I don't know when I'll hit that goal. I don't even know if I'll get one of those videos, but at least I know that having at least a destination to go to means that I can roughly, you know, make course corrections to get to that destination. Here, it's actually connected to my infinite goals. And if this looks complicated, by the way, I've actually created a Notion Skillshare course. You can check that out if you want to learn about this. Here, I've got a relation. So these two tables are connected, which makes sense because these two goals are connected. By having these two tables connected, it means that I can show the connections between them. So for example, here, if I click on the right 3 dots there, and I actually show the annual goals, you can see, let me just like move this Spy X Family to the side there for a sec. You can see the goals that are connected to different things. So for example, having fun is related to this particular goal, and these two tables are connected. So if I was to say, you know, set my goals a lot less lofty, make a 10 view video worthy video each fortnight, then it will automatically update in my infinite goals, but that's a bit too lame. Some of these are exceptionally lofty. For example, trying to reach 75 kilograms by the end of this year, that's gonna be pretty hard for me. But the way that you achieve these goals is you want to at least have some semblance of the metrics that you're using. You know, for example, a 1 million view video, I can see what the number is at any particular time. A, you know, financial stability, I can see what, you know, amount of cash I'm earning at any particular time. And similarly with weight, I can see what weight I'm at any particular time. So if I actually go down here, and then you can see that there's another bit called goal metrics. And so this is just something that I'm slowly filling out over time to sort of see, you know, what I'm doing and how much achievement I'm getting. So here in terms of goal metrics, the actual amount of dollars per month is a bit of a tricky one there because I'm getting a lot of Skillshare students, which is cool. My weight, if anything, it's probably increased. My subs have increased, which is good. So at least I can say now I have 1, 2, 5, 4 subs. Whereas back then, I can't remember how many I had. I should have noted that down. And then I've got the Darwin Analysis channel, which now has 8 subs, which is cool. And so it's a very small table over time. I mean, you know, I can show it again on this channel at some point in time to see what the actual result of everything is. So feel free to sub if you want to stick around for that. But the idea is that I want to track these metrics over time and then see which way they're going. So for example, now that I've got this particular metric here that says I'm increasing weight, I should think, there's something I'm not quite doing right about my diet, about my exercise. There's something that I need to fix. Being able to see these metrics is the thing that's going to shine a light on, oh, like this is something that I need to fix. And for me, it's not tied to like an ego thing, or at least I would hope it's not tied to an ego thing, because sometimes people might look at it and be like, oh no, I feel like super bad. For me, it's just, this is a problem, I need to fix it. You know, it's the same as an orthopedic surgeon. The bone is broken, there's a problem, I need to fix it. Same idea. So I'll focus on that soon. I've got my eventual projects list here. This is just another list for stuff I'd love to do at some point in time. For example, I'd love to learn Japanese at some point in time. I'd also love to create a 3D cinematic anime universe, but this is a project that's literally going to be like years in the future, so we'll see what happens with that. And then for achieving these different systems, I've got this master plan. These, by the way, are all just tables, as you can tell. Like, they're just database views. And for this one here, my master plan for achieving a few of these goals is to do these different YouTube channels. So for example, I've got the main one, which is the one that you're seeing right now. I'll eventually have a Darbido Clips and Shorts channel. I've got the Darby Analysis channel, which is up. So that one has some videos about YouTube storytelling for retention, if you're interested in that. And then that will also eventually need a Clips and Shorts. I had the idea to make medical videos, but that project is going to be a little bit on the back burner now. So I'm just going to type in this, May 30, oh, sorry. On May 30, June 7, 2022. And then here, I'm gonna just basically copy and paste this system and then, you know, maybe just get rid of this for the time, but that will be eventually. And I can chuck it actually in here. Because each of these cells, as you know, in Notion, can become its own page, which is super duper cool. Here, being able to see what my master plan is also gives me an insight into, okay, there's these different components. Like, how am I actually progressing on those different components? So like the Davido channel here, we're increasing the... So here is just going to be a brief status update of the stuff that I've got, just for my own sort of reference. So originally I had this full document talking about like what I want to do and like, you know, the different goals and that sort of thing and, you know, frameworks for it. But I found that I wasn't using this at all. Like, I had the great grand vision of just like, I want to create this gigantic plan and it's going to be amazing and it's going to tie together all these bits and pieces. And then when it came to the crunch, it never really got implemented in day-to-day life. So that's why instead of this one static master plan, I've created the TODO productivity systems way of doing it, which is that this is an evolving plan, and I'm going to try to keep it relatively simple, but the plan evolves as I learn more and more and more. It's kind of straightforward when you're like doing an academic course or something, because you know what you need to study, you know what's in the curriculum, you don't really need to course correct that much. But when you're doing something where a lot of the data that you're collecting is experimental, a lot of the growth that you're doing is also experimental, having a dynamic system like this is actually going to be much more useful. Or at least I've found something like this useful. But then the next question is, okay, like if stuff is changing all the time, your plans are very dynamic and you course correct a lot, how do you actually record those? And so here I've got a special table for recording it as well, called the TODO YouTube Strategies, Experiments, and Reflections table. And so some of the things I do are case studies. For example, when I post a new YouTube video, I actually analyze that video to be like, oh, okay, like what's happened with that video? What are the things that did well? What are the things that didn't do well? And what are the things that I should think about fixing? But there are some reflections that I did notice. For example, it was an iPhone video. However, most of the people that actually talked to me about it in person were like, oh, that was really great. I watched it even though I don't have an iPhone. And that's not really like the kind of sort of thing I want. My mum found it too fast to understand, so I might need to slow down the pacing. That's something I need to learn, which I'm not learning for this video because we're going through things fast. But I did get some good feedback, you know? So for example, my friend told me that his wife actually used that video and it really helped them because his wife was having some problems with like photos. And so he turned around and it was like, my boy Davido has got you covered. So then that made me sort of realize, oh, like I just need to really create helpful stuff that's really, really good for people's lives. And then, you know, those may be objectively good videos that people actually remember. And yeah, that was just a fun experience. Here, I did a video yesterday night on neural radiance fields, which is a fascinating concept in AI/technology. But it sucked in terms of the number of views. It's a very, very niche topic. The reason I did it is because I wanted to capitalize on Apple probably doing it sometime in their WWDC. But as I wrote, it's got poor retention. It's an extremely niche topic choice. And the science style storytelling is probably, you know, it's a little bit serious and it's a little bit more boring potentially. So I've got to think about how I infuse better storytelling in that. Here, I've got a little hammer and spanner emoji to tell me, these are things I need to fix. So here I wrote, I think it's getting a bit YOLO. I should probably focus down on an actual defined audience. My current audience avatar is some mix between a few people that I know. So I categorize these different things into, so, you know, not everything is a case study on YouTube. Some of them, experiments. So for example, I want to experiment with the idea of a single idea video, which is a very, very short video. And I have no idea whether that's going to be a good thing or a bad thing, but I thought about the experiment. I thought, maybe it'll work, maybe it won't. This is something I think about because basically I've been thinking about stuff like building apps, you know, doing e-commerce, making music, composing music, and I find that sometimes you can get the information from different people and from different sources, but often the best way to get information, if you just have no way to get that information otherwise, just try it. See if it works, and if it doesn't work, then you know it doesn't work, and that's your experience now. But if it does work, and it's your like little secret, then that's really cool. Of course, each of these individual things can also be expanded to become their own page. Something that's pretty special about this particular table, instead of this table where I've got a date that I just have to manually put in, what I've actually done is I've created this formula so that whenever I add a new thing to the table, it will just automatically put the date in. If you wanted to create a system like this, but you wanted someone to give you more guidance on how to do it and, you know, go a lot slower through it, then I've actually created a Skillshare course on Notion. It's Notion for students and professionals, and it's really, really helpful if you're a university student or high school student, or if you're someone that needs to organize your life or your own career. This is a really, really helpful course, and so you can check that out. Link's going to be in the description and comments below. Otherwise, I'm going to make a few more videos on Notion and Obsidian, which is another note-taking software that I use. And if you care about stuff like tech and productivity and note-taking systems and mental models, then feel free to subscribe to this channel. Otherwise, I'll catch you later.